Hi friends, this is Anusha, your science teacher, here with you with the fourth lesson of seventh class, Motion and Time. This is seventh class, fourth lesson. Yes. What is motion? First, let us know what is this motion mean. Motion is nothing but in common meaning, we can say it is a movement. Moving from one place to another place. Moving from one place to another place. One place to another place. So, anything moving, you can say that movement. Movement is nothing but moving from one place to another place. It's nothing but the motion. In our daily life, we see many types of motions, isn't it? Birds flying. Animals movement. And when we are walking also, we experience movement, isn't it? So, in science, actually, what do you mean by motion? Which body is said to be in the motion? And about this motion in detail, we will learn. So in common language, you use many times, it is in movement, it is in motion, like that we use it. But what exactly it means? How we should calculate the time and all, we will learn in this lesson. So let's go into our topic. Motion is a common experience in our life. Motion everywhere, as I said, something is moving from one place to another, like bus is moving from one place to another place. Okay, like dog moving from one place to another place, or any vehicle or any animal or any human being moving from one place to another place, then we say it is in motion normally, isn't it? Yeah, listen. So we observe birds flying in air. Birds flying in air means what? They are changing their position. Birds flying in air means what? They are changing the position from one place to another place, isn't it? So it is a movement, isn't it? It is not in the same place. It is moving from one place to another place. Means it is in motion. So it's a movement, you can say. Next, buses move from one place to another place, autos, isn't it? And cars, bullock carts moving on roads, trains on railway tracks, and many other objects around us in motion. So these all are we observe in daily life. If you close your eyes and think, there are so many moving from one place to another place. Okay, the bus is moving from one place to another place. Birds are flying. Okay, we think sometimes we feel that when we are going in a bus also, we feel that shops on the road are also moving because they are moving from one place to another place. As we are in the bus, we feel that even the shops are also moving, isn't it? Let us get clarified about what is the motion exactly mean, what do you mean by it, and all with a clear knowledge we will get into it. Okay, next. Apart from observing motions of objects around us, we are ourselves experience motions while we are walking, running, playing, riding a bicycles, etc. Yeah. When we are walking from one place to another place, we are walking from one place to another means we are making a move. What we are doing? We are making a move from some X position to Y position. Isn't it? Means we are walking, we are in motion, we feel. When we are riding a bicycle, what do you mean riding a bicycle? You just don't sit on the bicycle, isn't it? So we will move on the bicycle. It's a movement, isn't it? Next, similarly, we observe many objects like trees, buildings, display boards, electric poles, etc. are in rest when we are in walk, isn't it? So when we move from one place to another place, get clarity. When we move from one place to another place, we say they are in motion, isn't it? Moving from one place to another, one place to another. Anything, when we move from one place to another place, let it be a small distance or large distance or something, when we move from one place to another place, we say it is in motion. So another world is also there, which is very, very important to know, that is at rest. Rest, isn't it? Like shops, they don't move. Mobile shops, it's okay. Normally the shops, they don't move. And shops, they don't move. And electric poles, they are not moving from one place to another place. We say they are in rest. Okay, when they don't move from one place to another place, like shop, like whatever, anything you can take as example. If it does not move from one place to another place, then we land. It does not move from one place to another place. It is in rest, we'll say. Isn't it? House. When you walk, you say house. Is it moving from one place to another place? No. It is in rest, you will say. Got clarity now. Next, we will go. Other than running, playing and walking, when do you experience motion? Motion. Prepare a list. So, other than walking, when you walk from one place to another place, you move and you feel that, yeah, we are in motion. And when you are playing also, okay. More than that, you are supposed to write a list of it. And next, when we sit inside a moving bus or a train, we observe that the objects like trees, buildings, electric poles are moving. We are saying that, see, electric poles will move from one place to another place. No. But when we are sitting in a bus, or we are sitting on a car, or we are sitting in a something, auto or something, we feel that even the shops are moving with us. Shops are moving, we feel that they went back. Is it so really they are moving back? No. Is they are in rest? As they are not moving from one place to another place, we will say that they are in rest. Or we are feeling when we are sitting in bus or something that, we are traveling in a bus. Suppose. See, we are traveling in a bus. Okay, we are sitting in a bus. There are shops. Okay. And there are some houses. Or there are some schools, let us say. We feel that they are not moving from one place to another place. But still we will feel that they are moving. They are not in rest. They are moving. We feel that, isn't it? When you are traveling in a bus. So, let us see what do you mean exactly in science by motion and rest. So in detail we learn about this motion and rest. What do you mean by motion and what do you mean by rest? Okay, here is the picture. What can you observe in this picture? My first question is, what difference do you notice in the position of the car? So, you ignore my drawing. This is the car. This is position 1. This is position 2. Okay. And 2 seconds later, this is a position. 2 seconds later, this is the position. So, what happened to the car after 2 seconds? It has changed its... It has moved from this position to this position. The same tree. Here is the same tree. But after 2 seconds, the position of the car is this. Means what? It is behind the tree before 2 seconds. It is after the tree before, after 2 seconds. Means what do you mean by it? The car has changed its position. So what difference do you notice in the position of the tree? What difference do you notice in the position of the car first? Position of the car changed. Isn't it? Moved. Changed. Change in the position of the car. The car is in motion, you can say. Isn't it? Car changed its position, you can write. Car changed its position. Car changed its position. Its position. Okay. Next one. What difference do you notice in the position of the tree? Do you notice? What difference do you notice? Its place, you can say. Place or a position, whatever you say. Place. Okay. What a difference do you notice in position of tree? Do you notice any change in the position of the tree? Do you notice any change in the position of the tree? Yes. What is the what is the difference in it? This tree is front of this car before 2 seconds. After 2 seconds, the position of the tree is back of the car. Got it? Next. Why has this difference occurred? Is it because the tree moved to the right of the car or car moved to the left of the tree? So here what happened first? I said before and after. Na? In the book they have given that tree is, now this is the car. Left, my left hand side car is there. On the right hand side tree is there. So tree is right to the car. Okay, in the second position, the question asked. The second position, what happened? Tree has moved. Isn't it? Left of the position. Now tree is in left. Means it has changed its position. Why? The tree has moved. The tree has moved from one place to another place. No, car has moved from one position to another position. Now, see. We know that position of the car has changed with respect to the tree in 2 seconds. But there is no change in the position of the tree with respect to its surroundings. It is an important para you need to remember. See, position of the tree. Now, the question is, we are in the second question, we have discussed that the tree has changed its position. The tree has changed its position. Clearly, you should understand. The tree has changed its position, we have discussed. Here is the another point to be remembered is, yes, tree has changed its position with respect to the car. See, I am sitting, two persons are there. Two persons are there. One is sitting in the car. Another is sitting on the bench near the tree. Okay. Now, what happened? This person who is sitting in the car will say that tree is moving. Tree is moving with respect to the car. According to his observation, he said that first the tree is on the right side and after 2 seconds tree is in the left side. So he obviously say yes, the tree has moved from its position. But the person who is sitting on that bench, he will say that the tree is not moving at all. Even the compared to all the surroundings around this tree, and any surroundings are there with respect to some shop. You hear the shop is there. If you stand in the shop, or you are if you see with respect to the shop, then also you will say the tree is in the rest. Only when you sit in the car, then only we say that the tree is moving. How? Why like that? One is saying the tree is in the rest at the same time. Another is saying that tree is in moving motion in the same time. How is it possible for the one to be at rest and it is at in motion at the same time? So, motion here is a relative property, relative thing. Motion here is a relative quantity, you can say. So, with respect to the observer, we can say that something is at rest. If you get down of the car and see, stand for 5 minutes and see, you say that, you will only say that the car, the bench, the tree is not moving. If you go in a car, you will say that the tree is, if you get out of the car, you say that the tree is in rest. When you are in car, you will say that the tree is in motion. How? Means the motion, an object, how can we decide an object to be at rest or in motion? Means with respect to the observer. With respect to the observer, we say that the object is at rest or in motion. So, observer is in the car, he will say that the tree is moving. Observer, respect to the surroundings, or he is out, then he say that it is not moving. So, an object at rest or in motion can be decided by the observer. The object to state, it depends on what? To state if an object is at rest. To state for an object, the state of an object, whether it is in motion or in the rest, is decided by the observer. Is decided by the observer. Means what? To the one observer, the same object may be at rest like tree. And for other object, the same object may be at rest, they will say that it is not at all moving. It depends. The object is in, to get a clarity when whether an object is at motion or at rest, it depends upon the observer. Observer decides whether an object is at rest or in motion. So here is a statement. An object is said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to the surroundings in a given time. An object is said to be in motion. The object is said to be in the motion if it change . So, an object is said to be in motion if it change its position with respect to its surroundings within a given time. An object is said to be in motion. Means what? When you will say an object is in motion, when it changes its position. When it changes its position, means like tree in the case of car. When you are sitting in the car, and if the tree is with respect to the tree, a motion, an object is said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to its surroundings in a given time. So any object is there. When we say we are in the train, suppose we are in train, some shop is there. So when we are going in a train, we say that the shop is in motion. Means what? As the train is moving, we feel that the shop is moving its position. We feel that it is going back. Isn't it? So, with respect to its surroundings, an object is said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to its surroundings in a given time. So, if an object changes its position, when it changes its position with respect to its surroundings in the given time. So see, a flight, aeroplane flying from the airport means what? It is changing its position with respect to the surroundings. It is in motion, you can say. A train leaving the platform, it is moving with the surroundings. Means what? When you compare to the shops around it, when it compare to the platform, it is moving. So it is in motion, you can say. Okay, next. In your pendulum clock, pendulum, in the clock, pendulum will be there. It will be moving, isn't it? But moving its position from one place to another place with respect to its surroundings, with respect to the clock and all. So these are in motion, you can say. In a given, an object is said to be in rest. If there is no change in its position with respect to the surroundings. See, an object is said to be at rest. When you will say an object is at rest, you are standing in a park. Shop is there in a park. I think it is not visible to you. I'll use this. Yeah. A shop is there. Okay. Shop. Near that shop you are standing. Is that shop is moving with respect to you? Is shop is moving? No. You will say that shop is at rest. Okay. Next example. When you are sitting in a car. Sitting in a bus or a car, you can say. In a bus or a car, you can say. Means what does it mean? When you are sitting in a bus or a car. What does it mean? Means you are sitting in a bus. So the co-passenger of yours will feel that you are at rest. Isn't it? At the same time. If you see from the bus to the shop outside, you feel that the shop is moving. But the person who is standing near the shop, he feels that shop is at rest. Means respective to the surroundings, if it is not changing its position, you say that it is at rest. Okay. In detail, we'll go with what is a motion, what are the types of motions and all. So let's go.